If you've ever been overwhelmed trying to plan the dream vacation or a girls trip or anything of the sorts, going from various websites for hours, if not days, trying to piece together the perfect itinerary. Planning for a trip can be a lot. Now, think about it. You have your flight, you have reading countless reviews on the hotel, you're asking friends for recommendations, you're doing all the things, and then you gotta plan for activities. And it's even better when you have to travel with someone and consider all their specific needs, right? That's great, right? Now, wouldn't it be nice if AI took care of all the heavy lifting? Now, in this example, we're gonna talk about Google Bard because just as the time of this publishing, Google Bard does a better job than ChatGPT. And the reason for that is it integrates with other Google products, which include Google Flights, Google Hotels, Google Maps, all of Google products, and you get real-time information. And the map, I'm telling you, comes in handy. Okay, so I am going to show you how you can create a personalized experience and using Google Bard as your travel assistant. Now, this can be beneficial if you already know where you're going, but even if you have no clue where you're going. So let's get into it. Okay, so now we're here at Google Bard, and you can reach Bard, of course, by going to bard.google.com and logging into your Google account. So for starters, we're just gonna find some flight information. Okay, can you show me flights from IAD to Lisbon to arrive in Lisbon on November 12th, 2023 and hotels close to Lisbon city center? So right now it's going through Google Hotels and Google Flights in real time. Now, at the beginning, gives you a little warning. Bard does not always get it right, so check your information. All right, now, I didn't give it a returning date. Of course, you can give it a returning date. It just based it off of that, so we'll go with it. It tells you how much it is round trip and how long it will take. So you can evaluate what makes sense right here. No going to various websites. Now, this also gives some hotels near the center of Lisbon. My Charm Lisbon Suites and a bunch of others, right? Here's the flight information. And then it gives you pricing and pictures and ratings, folks. of the various hotels. Now that happened in a matter of seconds. Next, let's say I'm in the mood for some Nepalese food and I wanna know what are some Nepalese restaurants close to the hotel I may be considering. Now look at this, again, in a matter of seconds, I have some recommendations, the address, and the ratings on Google Maps to the various places in which they have Nepalese food. Also, if I wanted to put in a reservation, I could just click here and do that. Along with the addresses, it even maps it out based on what train locations are located. So if you wanted to go here to the Nepal Curry House, you can get off at the Almada station. Super helpful. Now, let's say you want to know some tourist attractions you can go visit. So let's say you want to know some tourist attractions that you want to go visit, but you specifically want to go to tourist attractions that are accessible by public transportation. Well, let's ask. Sure, here's some tourist attractions. Now, again, in a matter of seconds, you have various recommendations on where you can go and how to get there. Even more, you're given a map yet again. You can even get Google Bard to plan out your itinerary. So Google's going through Google Maps and Google Flights and Google Hotels. Again, you have your warning, day one. Arrive at the hotel, take a walk, have dinner, restaurants in Alfama, day two, day three, and day four, day five, day six, day seven, depart from Lisbon. This is a full itinerary along with maps, flight information, and hotel options. Now, anywhere during this time, if you want Google Bard to use specific applications, i.e. YouTube, Google Hotels, or what have you, all you have to do is put the at symbol and ask your question. Now from here, you can pick where you want to at: Google Flights, Google Drive, Google Docs, Google Hotels, Maps. See why this is super helpful? So for this, we're just going to say YouTube. And we'll hit enter. And this will pull up various YouTube videos that you can watch, and you still didn't even have to leave the website yet. Here we have some titles. You can look at these and see if you find them interesting, and then you get the thumbnails. Now that's great and all when you know where you want to go, but what if you don't know where you want to go? What if you're just interested in traveling, you have a certain budget, and some other things you desire, and you want to create a trip that's specifically catered to you? Well, there's some options. Okay, so now you just gotta give Google Bard your personal information and give it as much information as possible. Can you recommend some places to travel in Europe based on my travel profile? Travel profile includes, I am traveling solo. I am a 44-year-old woman. I would like a place that is safe. I plan on traveling the month of January. I'm interested in a city that is suitable for a person with limited mobility. I would prefer somewhere where it's warm during the month of January. My local airport is Lisbon. I like hotel class of 3-star and guest rating of 4 or higher. My budget is 950 euros, which should include the flight and the hotel. So let's see what we come up with. Okay, so let's see what we have. I found a few warm European destinations in January that are safe and suitable for a person with limited mobility. So here you have some of your options. Now, Google actually gives a recommendation because the warmest weather in January is located here in Spain. Here, Google offers a time to leave because remember, we didn't give it that. January 7th through January 15th are the best time to leave based on the budget that you gave it. These are the reasonable flights. So you can just go to those airlines, book your flight. Here are some options for 3-star hotels with guest ratings of 4 or higher, along with their prices. And here you have some pictures that you can peruse to see if any of those locations or hotels look like something interesting to you. So this is just scratching the surface of the things that you can do. You can save a ton of time and energy. Whatever you want to do specifically, or the things that you like, or your travel profile, cater it specifically to you. These are just some examples. So I hope this was helpful. Do you understand how powerful this is and how quickly it was to just not start from a blank slate, and now you have information to go on as it relates to your travel information, and you can get as specific and as detailed and as personal as to what you specifically want. If you have children, if you're traveling with pets, you can include all that information into your travel profile or while you're talking to Google Bard and get recommendations. It is wonderful. Now, bunch of caveats. Of course, this is still a relatively new product, so there may be some glitches. So definitely be sure to check all of the information and make sure that it's accurate. But if this is any indication or just on the start, just imagine how amazing it's going to be later. Now, if you happen to be interested on how I traveled to Milan, Lake Como, and Lugano, Switzerland for only 700 euros, which included my flight and my hotel, check out this video.